Is the United States more secure today because of that?
You have said that Iran will retaliate for the targeted killing of General Qasem Soleimani. President Trump has said there would be a disproportionate response if you do that. What do you make of President Trump's threats?
His threats will not frighten us. But what he's showing something, he's showing to the international community that he has no respect for international law, that he is prepared to commit war crimes, because attacking cultural sites is a war crime. In this disproportionate response is a war crime. But he doesn't care, it seems, about international law. But has he made US more secure? Do Americans feel more secure? Are Americans welcome today in this region? Do they feel welcome?
Your government and your leadership and the military here has vowed to take action against the United States.
Well,
what kind of retaliation is that going to be?
The United States violated three principles: Iraqi sovereignty and the agreement that they had with Iraq. They got a response from the Iraqi parliament. They violated the emotions of the people. They will get a response from the people. They killed one of our most revered commanders and most senior commanders, and they took responsibility for it. This is state terrorism. This is an act of aggression against Iran, and it amounts to an armed attack against Iran, and we will respond. But we will respond proportionately, not disproportionately, because we are committed to law. We are law-abiding people. We're not lawless like President Trump.
So you think that you can strike at any point?
Well, we think...
Because you obviously... It's no secret that you control militias in this region, that you have forces that are on your side in this region, in many countries.
No, we have people on our side in this region. That's much more important. The United States believes that this beautiful military equipment, according to President Trump, that you spend $2 trillion on these beautiful military equipment. Beautiful military equipment don't rule the world. People rule the world. People. The United States has to wake up to the reality that the people of this region are enraged, that the people of this region want the United States out, and the United States cannot stay in this region with the people of the region not wanting it anymore.
Would it be worth speaking to him?
Well, he doesn't need speaking. He has to realize that he has been fed misinformation. And he needs to wake up and apologize. He has to apologize. He has to change course. He cannot add mistake upon another mistake. He is just making it worse for America. He is destroying the US Constitution. He is destroying the U.S. political process. He is destroying the rule of law in the United States. But that's not for me to say. That's a domestic affair of the United States. He has enraged the people of our region. He has killed people of this region. He has spent $1 trillion. He said that the U.S. had wasted $7 trillion in our region. He has added another trillion. Is the United States more secure today because of that?